Well, there's nothing more precious than human life. And this is a wonderful opportunity to all of us to sensitize our children. I see this to be a huge opportunity for all of us to tell people that their lives are more important than anything else. So calendars would be rescheduled. It's not a big issue. The only problem is that how do we organize our campuses once the session begins? Because COVID or the coronavirus disease is something which spreads with human contact. So once the colleges and institutions reopen, we've got close to what 1,000 students on our campus, and around 500 of them live in hostels. So I don't see much of a problem in rescheduling. We've already begun the exercise. We already are doing a lot of our work online. In fact, our classes are going as usual online through Zoom, Avaya, Google. You know, one of the most important ideas people must understand that we must be willing to understand that changes happen. We've been talking about cyber-physical systems for last 5 years or so, and now the industry 4.0 is almost there. We have, you know, what you call virtual augmented reality. We've got blockchain. We've got 3D printing in manufacturing. We've got APIs and DevOps. You've got analytics, artificial intelligence, cloud computing. Now, this requires that the child of tomorrow or a student of tomorrow will be working in a different industry. The right. problem of our education system is that it assumes that everything will remain the same throughout. No, it will not. The fact is that you've got to tell everybody that tomorrow's world is going to be different. Such events, when they happen, these are cataclysmic events where the world stops, COVID-19. We must think. Now, tomorrow's worker needs to have a different skill. Probably most of the people tomorrow would work from home. Probably you would have, say 5G is going to come to India by 2022, which will give you speeds up to 10 Gbps. Probably the kind of video conferencing we are doing today through Skype will become redundant, and all of us can engage with wider audiences. In fact, most office work would become online.
Absolutely.
You would see a much clearer, better world where the air pollution would go down. So the skill for tomorrow is changing. Educational institutions should not actually keep teaching the same thing. They must attach themselves to this idea of education 4.0, whether they are schools, whether they are colleges or higher educational institutions like ours. Like, for example, we have a course on big data analytics coming up this year. And this course basically aims at preparing students or managers for tomorrow, for tomorrow's world, where, you know, of course, the decisions will not always be taken by people sitting around each other. We would not be talking about dynamics of human behavior where people are in contact with each other because of infectious diseases.
Right.
But they'll be in touch with each other through digital platforms. So this is a beginning. We should look for a better skill set. We should look for newer skill sets in the individuals, and we should prepare new curriculum.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Let me tell you, these events happen once a 100 years. In 1918, we had a major influenza epidemic in India in which close to 1.4 crore people died. At that time, there were no testing facilities, even paracetamol was not. But the point is, if you look at the current situation, we've got high advances in medicine, we've got high advances in testing, and we now need to understand that viruses will keep coming again. They mutate. The best idea for parents today is to, even for schools and colleges, is to tell and teach their students and children, of course, at home, how to improve immunity. Improve your immunity. Education must have one of the major objectives that ensuring the better health for everyone. We must ensure that nothing will go wrong. Yes, of course, the poor will be hit. Those with weaker immunities will be hit. As I was trying to point out, the biggest calamity in any such epidemic are the poor and the underprivileged. We need to make an action plan. We need to ensure corporate social responsibility. Everyone needs to come out and support the poor people and poorer sections of the society.
Right.
It's about food, it's about education, it's about living a life. But for all those people around, the world is in a shutdown. there is no need to panic. Almost everybody must learn how to cope up with this shutdown. This is in our benefit. We must learn and adapt to the situation, and in future, the colleges and institutions must have this kind of a disaster management plan with them.
Right.
A country like India, where people are often irrational, do not understand that yes, such events happen and they'll keep happening. Several virus pandemics may occur in future as well. So it is better to start preparing. It's better to start putting these things in curriculum.
Right.
Panicking won't help at all.
Absolutely.
There are three major points which I have. One, now COVID-19 probably will give a lifeline to our telecommunication companies, which are very much under stress today because of the license fee issue. And they're not being able to buy servers and machines and other, like for example, Huawei servers and all, which are required for implementation of 5G. And it has been delayed by almost like 2 years. The second major idea is that the entire expenditure of the government and of course state government, as well as all educational institutions, now has to be relooked into. No longer do you want to create bigger classrooms, large mega size buildings. You need to now focus, if you want to educate, you need to focus on the digital infrastructure.
Absolutely.
And this digital infrastructure can be instituted, and it can be much lesser investment. Probably 10% of the investment of a large building, you can actually put up servers, and you can put up broadband infrastructure, you can put fiber optic cables. I'll give you an example here. There's a company of the government called Common Services Center, and I work with that company also. It's called CSE, Governance Services India Limited. We've got 350,000 common services centers across the country. And we have now tied up with this company to provide training to 50,000 rural Indians. This program will be rolled out from 1st of April, despite COVID-19, because it will be done through a digital infrastructure. Now, the point is that we need to change the way we spend money on education. Now, we only create content which can allow a young student, whether in rural or urban area, to analyze, evaluate, and create.
Right.
The biggest point, the third point is, do not create now online material which promotes rote learning. Let the rural people, urban people, everyone learn that you got to learn differently.